So I've been wanting to learn how to make games with Godot, and I joined the Beginner's Winter 2024 Game Jam to push myself to create and actually finish a game. The theme of the jam was revealed to be delivery, and after thinking long and hard, I decided to make a clicker game about running a delivery company. Here's a concept. A cardboard box with a random item slides into the screen on a conveyor belt. You click to package it, and as you do, the box dynamically changes. Afterward, you load the boxes into your truck and deliver them to customers, and you get some money. Sounds pretty simple to make, right? And with that, it is already day 4 of the game jam because I've been away on holidays, but let's finally get started. So I launched Godot, created a new project, and started by drawing the main box sprites as well as a progress bar and conveyor belt. I put the sprites in the game, added a button to the box, and made it increase the value of the bar when you click it. To change the box dynamically, I wrote a function that checks whether the bar is over a certain value, and if so, it changes the sprite's texture. Since this is a clicker game, if clicking feels bland and uninteresting, then what's the point? To fix that, I created a click animation for the box to make it more satisfying, as well as a slide in and out animation. I looked up a tutorial about tweening and made it so the progress bar smoothly goes back to zero. And I was like, if I can do that, can't I make it go up smoothly too? But no, it turns out I was wrong. It did not work.
Leave me alone!
Obviously, sound design is important, so I got some free click sound effects from JSFXR, then I went on OpenGameArt and found some cardboard impact sounds that I ended up using when the box changes textures. Then I created some UI for the amount of crates and money you have. Next, I started working on the loading section. And by that I mean I just copy-pasted everything from the packaging part and made some tiny tweaks to it. I drew some more sprites, a truck, a garage loading background area, and a bunch of packages. I wanted the boxes to slowly appear in the truck as you click, so I decided to give them a little pop-in animation. However, I ran into a problem. I couldn't figure out how to make animations reusable. For example, in Premiere, you can just drag and drop an animation preset wherever and it just works. Just like that. But I couldn't figure out how to do that in Godot for the life of me, so I just ended up creating new animations for each box manually. But to save time, I copy-pasted the keyframes and just renamed the animations. So I'm currently getting footage for the video. I just pasted the animation player into the boxes, and it works. I'm a complete idiot. As for the delivery, it was really simple. Just a bar that slowly fills up and speeds up when you click it. With the delivery done, the core gameplay loop was finally finished. Only one last task remained. It was the final day of the game jam, and I was racing against time to add a shop and upgrades to the game. I started by creating some small UI bars on the side of the screen that show which part of the game you're currently in. Above that, I added a shop button with a tiny slide animation when you hover over it. It breaks though if you get too silly with it. As time ticked away, I quickly added 5 different upgrades to the game. The speed upgrade boosts your click power, while packagers and loaders automate the packaging and loading process. To improve delivery times, you can hire drivers. And increasing your capacity is possible with the increased max crates upgrade. With the game finally finished and barely any time left, I was rushing to export it and upload it to itch.io. But of course, itch.io decided to have a bad day and I just couldn't get the game up no matter what I tried. Thankfully, the host of the game jam extended the deadline by a whopping 24 hours since many participants were facing the same issue. So I just went to sleep feeling real good that day. The next morning, with the extra time, I fixed a lot of bugs, sadly had to remove loaders because of the code, it was just really broken, successfully uploaded the game and spent way too long polishing the game page to make it look great. There were some amazing submissions in this jam, and honestly, seeing them made me regret not going for a 3D game, but hey, maybe next time. Out of 85 entries, I managed to place 32. I think that's pretty decent.